Hello guys, welcome back to the channel, welcome back to another video, and this video is related to swatches, as you guys have already seen the title of the video. So Shopify released product attributes back in Feb 2024 in the latest winter edition, but that feature hasn't been rolled out yet, and we haven't seen any store where we can apply the product attributes to achieve the color swatches. But what happened after that update, all of the old tutorials which we created stopped working, and the color swatches tutorial which I have created for Dawn 12.0, Dawn 9.0.0, and all of the previous themes stopped working. So this video is the fix for that. In this video, I'm going to show you guys how you can add color swatches to your product page, which will work on the latest version, Dawn 13.0.1. And when I say Dawn 13.0.1, I mean to say that it's going to work on all free themes of Shopify, color block, sense theme, whatever theme you are using, this tutorial is going to work completely fine. Also, I have created a separate playlist for all of the swatches tutorial which I have created. So as you can see on my screen, I have these tutorials showing up, and these are the six different tutorials which I already created. That today, the ones which I'm recording today, is going to be the seventh one. So as you can see, this is for conditional fields, and this one which I created 2 years ago, 1 year back, and this one was 11 months ago, and the latest one which I created stopped working when Dawn 13 got released. Right now, this video is showing you guys how you can implement that on Dawn 13.0.1. As you can see this on my store, so I'm running Dawn 13.0.0, and as you can see, I have these color swatches showing up, which are working completely fine. And if you go to customize settings, you can see what are the customization features we have after implementing this tutorial. So if you want to display color swatches, simply click on color. And if you want to display variant images, so simply click on variant image and it will switch to the variant image. You can change the color swatch style. So if you want round or square, you can have that square with rounded corners, portrait. So all of these features are basically the same. If you haven't watched my previous tutorial, I'll add the link in the description where I have shown you guys in detail what are the features which you will be having for free just by following this video. So make sure to watch till the end of the video. Also, don't forget to subscribe this channel if you want to have free features for your Shopify store which will help boost your sale, which will help improve UI of your Shopify store. Okay, we also have the swatches where we can increase the swatch size. So as you can see, I am increasing the swatch size. Now let's get it back to the 50 pixel. Yep, that's fine. And one thing to notice, as you have to add in the value here, whatever variation you want to display the color swatch to. So if you have COLOUR, make sure to add the same value here. If you do any spelling mistake, or if you have a different capitalization on your product page or in your customized setting, then it's not going to work. So make sure to note this field and make sure to fill it carefully. Also, you can add the custom color here. You can also add multicolors here if you want to, right? So for example, if you have multicolor showing up, so let me first switch to swatch type. And now let me show you how the multicolor will work. So I'll just replace the black here, which is showing this hex code as per here. I'm just going to replace it with the multicolor, just to show you guys how it's going to work. You can see now I have two colors showing up in swatch. Similarly, we can display three colors. So all you have to do is just update the hex code to your color value and it will show these colors. Cool, right? So all of these features I have already shown you guys on the previous video. I'm going to add in the link in the video. If I miss anything, you can simply ask in the comments below. Okay, now let's start implementing that. And that's the tutorial, that's the code instruction, which you will find in the YouTube video description. So all you have to do is follow it step by step. So we have three steps in which we'll implement this, and we will do this in the latest version of Dawn theme. So that's theme. And I also have multiple videos to enhance the UI of the homepage. So if you want to implement transparent header and autoplay video, which you are seeing on my development store, you can have that free of cost, link in the description below. Okay, so let's get back to the backend of my development store. I'm going to close the customize window. Okay, click on online store. And this is the theme where I have already added the color swatches. I'm going to install a fresh Dawn theme in order to show you guys. So click on add button here. So while this is installing, guys, make sure to subscribe this channel, which will help me create more valuable content. Also, there is a link in the description through which if you sign up to your Shopify store, you'll have it only on $1 per month. So make sure to check that out as well. Okay, guys, so our Dawn 13.0.1 has been installed. I'm going to publish that. Click on publish and then publish again. And now let's preview that. I'm going to close this tab here. And that's the product where we have color variation. Now you can see that that's how the default version looks like. And now we will add color swatches to this one. Let's start doing that. And on my published theme, I'm going to click on these three small dots and then click edit code. Guys, before editing the code, make sure to have a backup of your theme. I always receive multiple comments regarding the code broken the theme completely. I'm not responsible for that, because if you already have the customization or if you have any app which is conflicting with the code, then you should have a backup of your theme. So in case it happens, you can easily revert it back. Okay, now click on edit code. And now we will follow this blog post. Link will be in the description. So first step is to add code in schema. So we will add the following code in schema. Let's search for settings underscore schema. That's the file. And we will add our code below this comma here. So I'm going to hit enter to add a line break and going to click on copy code button and then paste the code here. Perfect. After pasting the code, hit save. And now let's move on to the next step. So that's the next step where we will replace the code in product-variant-picker.liquid file. You will find the code in line number 52. Line number might not be same if you already have the customization. So if you are using a fresh Dawn 13.0.1, then it should be on line number 52. And the code will look like this. So we will replace this field set with the following code here. Okay. Now let's go to product-variant-picker. Search for it. And now we will search this code here. So I'm just going to copy this part of the code and try to find where it is. And this is one. We are not going to replace that one. We are going to replace this one. So field set, which is after picker type button, okay, which is in line number 52 to 60. Okay, so I have selected that and I'm going to replace this with the following code. Click on copy code and paste it here. Perfect, it's save. And now I'll move on to the next step. Next step is that we will create a snippet file, which will be called color-option. So let's create that snippet file. So So here we have snippet folder. I'm going to click on add a new snippet and then add in color dash option. Make sure to not to do any spelling mistake or change this file name because it's called in our product dash variant dash picker file. Okay, click on done. And now let's copy this code here. Click on copy code button and then paste the code. Perfect, it's safe. And now let's go to our customize settings. And go to theme settings. We should have color swatches option showing up here. And we have added this color option here, which should be same as this. So make sure to spell it as it is and have the same capitalization. Okay, now if we hit refresh, you can see that our color swatches are showing up, but the orange color is not showing up. The reason why is that we haven't yet defined the orange color. So we do not have orange color here. We haven't added the hexadecimal value for our orange color. So let's add in that orange. And now I'm going to add the hex code and I'll pull up the color from this t-shirt here by using my inspect tool. So that's the color code. I'm going to copy this color code and paste it here. Perfect. And then hit save. Let's open up the product template here as well. And now you can see that our orange color is showing up the same as the value we added here. And if we do not want to display the color swatches, we want to display the variant images. We can do that by selecting on variant image here. And you can see that we have now variant image showing up. Completely fine. Again, we can change the swatch size, which I already showed you guys. Now let me show you guys how you can add custom variant image. So these images are being pulled from the product variant. Let me go to the backend and show you guys. I'm going to go to that product where we have color swatches. So that's the product. And it's showing these variant images, which are being pulled from here on the product backend. So here I have selected this black image, blue image, and orange image, which is being pulled on the product page template here. But what if I want to add in the custom images? How can I do that? You can do that as well. So simply select swatch type color first. And now I'm going to add a new swatch in order to show you guys a new color. So let's add in purple. Click save. Let's go back and now add in the value of purple. Here we have the purple color, but it's currently blank. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to display my custom image here and I'm going to go to my content and files. So here we have content where we will see uploaded files. So here is the uploaded files. You can upload your own custom variant image to display. I'm going to display this image here. So I'm going to copy the URL handle and paste it here and then add in the image extension, which is .png. And now you can see that it's showing custom variant image. Now you can display this, all of the colors, black, blue, orange, and whatever color you have. That's it for the tutorial, guys. I hope you will be able to add in this feature to your store and will let me know in the comments below if you find any issues. And until next video, have a great day.